Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at the North American stock markets for Wednesday morning. We're coming up to the market open and stock index futures are fairly flat. Gold's up $8. Crude oil, natural gas fairly quiet in the pre-market on Wednesday. I don't need to be overly chatty this morning, just a couple of key points to get across. Nothing to worry about on Wednesday morning. The headlines are certainly positive. Markets making 52-week, or some of them are making all-time highs right now. So we saw the S&P 500 up on Tuesday. What we didn't see was volume. And this line across the middle of the screen is a 50-day moving average of volume. You can see we're well below the 50-day moving average. This is the SPDR tracking ETF, which tracks the S&P 500. And yes, the NASDAQ was up yesterday ever so slightly, but volume was down. You can see volume's just evaporating here. And so while we're hitting these all-time highs, not a lot of people are participating. So just something to be aware of. Certainly nothing to be concerned about on Wednesday morning. Looking at our commodity ETF, starting with our tracking ETF, it was down a penny yesterday. Copper was up, and copper's up dealing with the bottom of this open gap. We'll have to see how that does on Wednesday. There's gold, and gold actually had a bullish reversal day on Tuesday, and so we're seeing gold up about $8 this morning, so we may be putting in a bottom here. A similar situation for platinum, and platinum closed above the 112.50 level yesterday, so bullish reversal day for platinum. Silver was down yesterday, but off its lows. No bullish reversal day for silver, but certainly platinum and gold moving higher could help silver. There's crude oil, was down 7 cents yesterday on the ETF inside day. No major move there. Similar situation for gold. And there's natural gas up on Tuesday. Hasn't taken out the recent high from 3 days ago, and it's trading a little higher this morning. Looking at our pieces of the puzzle, Janet Yellen was speaking yesterday. Bonds were up sharply, not enough to give us a buy signal in the futures contract, but the futures contract stops trading before the stock market does. And so we saw more follow through to the upside in the TLT, which is back on a buy signal. And we saw Canadian bonds move higher on Tuesday as well. And so the Canadian bond ETFs are also back on buy signals. Now, not a lot of movement in the currency market on Tuesday, whether it's the US dollar, the euro, or the Canadian dollar. And looking at stocks, the VIX has come down into a range where it's found support previously. So we've got a pressure zone forming there. We're down near support. So if you didn't take profits on the way up last time, you know, this isn't the time and place to be selling. I'm looking for buying opportunities down here to add to my position. And then we'll look for another run up. And we might be a little more aggressive taking profits next time the VIX starts to move higher. There's the S&P 500 cash index. A close on Wednesday below 2078.64 would give us a sell signal. Not expecting that to happen. 2125 is our next target. Got as high as just under 2118 yesterday. So just a few points away from hitting the top of our projected trading range on the daily charts. When we look at the hourly charts, we'll show you some targets just above that. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for a close below 43.4493 on Tuesday. Not expecting that to happen. And we're still stuck at resistance at 44.5313, closed at 44.51 and change on Tuesday. There's the TSX. We're up this morning. Royal Bank reported, and there's a bid into bank stocks this morning. We need to close below 15,101. On Wednesday to give us a sell signal for the TSX, still trying to break through 15,312.50. Now, what worked yesterday, coal stocks were up, housing stocks were up in the U.S. In Canada, it was metals and mining stocks, and the consumer staples. That's what worked on Tuesday. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a couple of 60-minute charts. We've got the VIX oversold at the moment. We've got the stock market overbought. We're looking for that to change in the not-so-distant future. The first sign that something's happening on Wednesday is going to be a VIX above 1443 or the S&P 500 below 2109.22. You can see we're getting pretty close to that 2125 level. If we take that out, 2140, 2156 and change are next targets to the upside. For the TSX, we're still stuck in the middle of the range. We've been trying to break out above 15,312.50 or below 15,000 this week. We talked about our playing field earlier in the week, and so we're still looking for a breakout of that range. We talked about moving from using the right side chart to moving the midterm chart, and that didn't really help as we reversed yesterday. So an hourly close below yesterday's low would give us a new intraday sell signal for the TSX. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.